I rise also in support of this bill. You know, this has been, in my view, this is the top issue for the legislative session for 2023. It was a disappointment that we didn't get it done in the 105 days, but I'm very proud of the fact that we stuck with it. The folks from both sides of the aisle, folks from both sides of the rotunda, stuck with it. And we're gonna, I think today, get this across the finish line and get good policy, not perfect policy, but good policy for the people of the state of Washington. You know, Mr. President, this has been a long journey since the state Supreme Court made its Blake decision in 2021. We've seen some highs and lows. We've had periods of good bipartisan work on this issue. Other periods were less bipartisan, but we've persevered, I think, in good faith. And we are at a place today where, as the Senator Robinson said, we have a statewide solution in front of us. One that is workable by our prosecutors, by our law enforcement, one that provides treatment, one that is absolutely focused on getting people into treatment, keeping them in treatment, and hopefully returning them to normal lives, productive lives. It's one that has a wide variety of options for diversion based on the situation, one that gives the prosecutor some discretion, but also makes sure, again, that we're focused on treatment. One that provides a statewide solution, but also says there's some issues that are very controversial that really need to be dealt with at the local level, and protects the ability of cities and counties to shape the policy to fit their communities. I want to take a moment to thank everybody that was involved. There's a number of folks on both sides of the aisle who worked, and we didn't agree, as you might expect, Mr. President, we didn't agree on many things, but stayed committed, in particular Senator Robinson, who has carried a heavy load with this bill. The leadership of the Senate Democratic Caucus has been absolutely focused on finding a solution, and I want to thank them for that. We have a tough situation in our state, Mr. President, and we all like to talk about data, and it's hard given the time frame we have and the many factors in this to show causality. But as we look at our challenge in the state with overdose deaths over the last couple years, it's now the top cause of death for folks under 60 in our state. We've seen our growth in overdoses rise, I think, with the second highest in the country, only behind Vermont, which is dealing with a much, much smaller population. We're headed in the wrong direction. I saw some data just a couple days ago about overdose deaths in King County, and I'm not trying to separate out King County. This exists across our state. It's just a little easier to get data there. You know, in 2020, prior to the Blake decision, we had about 500 overdose deaths. We had the Blake decision in 2021, there's just over 700. Last year, there were about 1,000. Today, in May, middle of May of 2023, we're over 500, on a path to be at 1,500 deaths, nearly a 3 times increase in the number of overdose deaths in our state. Now, again, we can't say that's caused by the Blake decision. We can't say that's caused by the policy. But I think common sense would say, if we want to save people's lives, if we want to help people, and I think everyone in this chamber does, we have to try something different. And I think this bill in front of us balances that. It says we're focused on treatment, but we have to provide tools for our law enforcement officers, for our prosecutors, to help keep people in treatment, help them successfully complete treatment. You know, Mr. President, two years ago when we started this journey, I had at the time a nephew who was struggling with drug addiction. Sadly, he passed away, as you may recall, in April of 2021. I've thought a lot about him over the last few months, in particular the last few weeks. What could we do differently here in the state of Washington that would save people like Isaac in the future? You know, I think and I don't have to tell few folks on this floor, Mr. President, as Senator Robin said, nearly every one of us has some personal connection, whether it's a family member, a friend, a coworker who has struggled with some sort of drug addiction. But you think about, you know, I think about, you know, in the last year as I talked to Isaac's parents, and what they've had in some ways a good year. They have a daughter that got married. I had a chance to attend a wedding for his sister, their daughter, last year. It was a beautiful wedding, but there was something missing, and you could tell from the expression on his parents' face that they were still in mourning. This is a year later, a year and a half later. He missed a wedding. He missed an engagement. All these things that people in our lives, they should have been there, they could have been there, and weren't, because we weren't doing the things necessary to save their lives. Mr. President, I think this bill will help. I don't think that it's going to solve all our problems. I think we're going to have challenges ahead. But it's a strong step in the right direction, and one that I hope each of us will follow through on to make sure, as we identify places where it falls short, as we identify places where we need to add additional funding, as we find opportunities to do better, that we all remain committed to doing better. But today, I think we should take this step. We should all support this bill, move it to the House and off onto the governor, and get our state the policy it needs, the policy these people deserve, to get them the treatment to keep them alive. Thank you, Mr. President.